Hello students, welcome to SUFFA e-class. In the previous lecture, we have studied about the gravitational force and Newton's universal law of gravitation. Today, we will see Newton's universal law of gravitation in detail. So, what is Newton's universal law of gravitation? In the previous lecture, I show you the definition of gravitational force, a force by which Earth attracts the bodies towards itself, or the force by which every body in the universe attracts every other body. It is nothing but a gravitational force. So student, have you remember the statement of Newton's universal law of gravitation? Yes. What is Newton's universal law of gravitation? Every body in the universe attract every other body with a force which is directly proportional to the product of their masses and inversely proportional to the square of distance between them. Student, this is the Newton's universal law of gravitation. Learn it by heart. Yes. Every body in the universe attracts every other body with a force which is directly proportional to the product of their masses and inversely proportional to the square of distance between them. Again, I will draw the diagram. This is body A with mass m1 and this is body B with mass m2. And the distance between these two bodies is r. So according to Newton's universal law of gravitation, let F be the gravitational force by which every body attracts every other body in the universe. And this F, according to the first statement, this force is directly proportional to the product of their masses. So F is directly proportional to m1 multiplied by m2. It is the product of masses of both the bodies. And second statement is inversely proportional to the square of distance between them. So the distance between them is r and it is inversely proportional. So F inversely proportional to the square of distance between them. So F alpha 1 upon r square. So student, if we will combine these two mathematical statement, then we will get F alpha m1 multiplied by m2 upon r square. Means in this statement, both the mathematical statement will be combined and F will be directly proportional to m1 multiplied by m2 and upon r square. So student, in order to get the value of F, we have to put the constant here. For removing this alpha, we have to put constant here. So we will take constant as g. F is equal to, we will take g as constant here. I will show you what is g. So F is equal to g m1 multiplied by m2 by r square. Student, this is the formula for gravitational force and it is derived by the Newton's universal law of gravitation. Student, this F is equal to g m1 multiplied by m2 by r square, where g is constant. This g is called Newton's universal gravitational constant. It is universal gravitational constant or universal constant of gravitation. Yes. The value of this g is equal to 6.67 multiplied by 10 raised to power minus 11 Newton meter square per kg square. Or you can write 6.67 multiplied by 10 raised to power minus 11 Newton meter square kg raised to power minus 2. You can also write like this. So student, this is very important part of our chapter. Many derivations are depend on this Newton's universal law of gravitation. I will revise it one more time. So Newton's universal law of gravitation, every body in the universe attract every other body with a force which is directly proportional to the product of their masses and inversely proportional to the square of distance between them. So F alpha m1 multiplied by m2, F alpha 1 by r square. After combining both the equation, F alpha m1 multiplied by m2 by r square. So F is equal to, we will remove alpha, we will put the constant here, F is equal to g m1 multiplied by m2 by r square. Here g is Newton's universal gravitational constant. G is equal to 6.67 multiplied by 10 raised to power minus 11 Newton meter square per kg square, or 6.67 multiplied by 10 raised to power minus 11 Newton meter square kg raised to power minus 2. So student, note it.